Good day. Let us clarify a few points about the Pumbaa Guide. Since this course is focusing on applying the Pumbaa Guide, it's important that we start with stressing and clarifying a few important points. These points are critical for you to reflect on as you go through the material. And if you study and you go from mission to mission, you know, keep this video in mind. There are so many misunderstandings about the guide. So let's identify a few of them here. And I will focus on five items today. The first item, and which is a common misunderstanding in the community of project management today, is that some want to use the Pumbaa Guide as a methodology. Well, it is not a methodology. Now, of course, here some people might think it's an opinion, it's not an opinion, and I will be listing in the mission the actual quotation from the book itself to reflect on these important points. So the first point, the Pumbaa Guide is not a methodology. It is not designed to be a methodology, and if it is need to serve its intent and purpose, it cannot be a methodology. So it's very important to understand that the Pumbaa is designed for organization to use it to develop their own methodologies. So that's a very important first point. The second point we want to raise here is that the book short name is called, or actually let's start with the full name. The full name, it is a guide to the project management body of knowledge. That's a full name. The short name and the most common name, it's a Pumbaa Guide. Unfortunately, many people refer to it as a Pumbaa. Technically, this is not correct. Now, let's avoid and not go about convenience. It's more convenient to write it as a Pumbaa versus Pumbaa Guide. Convenience is one side. Let's focus on the real issue here. Okay, the real issue is that the word Pumbaa stands for the Project Management Body of Knowledge. And PMI itself is clear that this book is not the body of knowledge. The body of knowledge cannot be summarized in one reference or one book or one guide, even if it is 800 pages. So the issue here is that we need to understand that this is a guide to the body of knowledge. Yeah, and what does it mean in real life? How is it different? Well, it's different is because some people treat this book as the holy book. Well, it's not. And what PMI is clear is telling us, it is not. Yeah, which means you need to have other resources and references from other areas. Three, the process group versus project phases. Unfortunately, despite the numerous articles and posts that we and others have posted online, some people still think that the process group are project phases. The Pumbaa clearly state that the process group should repeat in every phase. They are not project phases. Number four is related to number three, which is project life cycle. When we ask people to name the project life cycle, often enough they come up with the process group names. So they will talk about initiating, planning, executing, and even controlling. They put it as a phase and closing phase. Now, some people exclude controlling and they would say, well, the project phases are initiating, planning, executing, and controlling. In a way, they would say, yeah, we understand that the project phases, the process group are not project phases, but then when you ask them about the project life cycle, they use those names as the phases of the project life cycle. Finally, this is, we've seen many posts about this that basically lists that what is the first document that the project manager should produce. Well, this is an important point, and then you can see a lot of PMP instructors, PMP consultants, and other so-called experts to say, well, the charter is the first document that the project manager produced. Well, technically, that's not correct, or is the first document on the project. Sorry, not the project manager, it's the first document on the project. That cannot be true, and that's not the Pumbaa. The Pumbaa doesn't say that. The charter is the output of the first process. However, that process have input, and those input are also documents. Yeah, assuming this is the first phase of the project. So please be careful. Understand the Pumbaa. understand the intent and the purpose of the Pumbak. Thank you.